This is day three of my demonstrations, the demonstration of my warm-ups. And I walk my dogs every day in my neighborhood in Ajijic, Mexico. And I'm looking for inspirational topics. And today I picked up these beautiful blue flowers that I'm gonna sketch. And then I'm gonna add acrylic paint. I use fluid acrylics and I use them in watercolor technique, and I'm going to explain to you what what makes it be a watercolor technique. I am Cristi. I am co-founder of Cristi Farrar Studio, and I've been painting all my life. I do have former degrees from different colleges in the States, and I live in Mexico. I picked up these two flowers to paint. So first I'm looking at the structure of the flower. So I'm looking at the overall shape, I'm looking at the number of the petals, and I am starting with the petal that is closest to me. When I paint flowers or bushes or trees, I tend to look at the subject more than I look at the paper. So I have the confidence that my hand, it's gonna follow what my eye sees. The moment we are looking at the paper, we are drawing or sketching from memory. It's no longer the object that we are sketching that it's directing the lines that, or the brush strokes that we're making. It's our memory. Now I continue sketching. So I want to explain a little bit what is the difference between a drawing and a sketch. When I sketch, I am looking to capture more the feeling of the plant or the feeling of the landscape or the street scene. I am less interested in perfection. If I would do a drawing of these flowers, let's say a botanical drawing of this flower, I will pay more attention to the shapes and the negative space. So I will try to reproduce as much as I can what I see. When I sketch, I am more interested in capturing how it feels to have a relationship with this plant, with this flower. I am connecting with it in a different way. So it's more of the feeling, the energy, the emotion. All these are contained into what we draw, even if we draw a stone. So this is my intention here, and it has many very wonderful details that if I would draw, I think I would be very interested in capturing. So now I'm gonna add the paint, and I am using acrylics. I am using acrylic paint, and those acrylics are fluid. So what means to be fluid? It means that it's very watery. It's not a heavy body acrylic that comes from a tube. They come in a bottle. I am in Mexico, so I'm using Mexican paint. So if I tell you the colors the paints that I'm using, like Pinto, Gamma Color, probably you're not gonna find them in your country unless you are in Mexico. And what makes it a watercolor technique is the fact that I use a lot of water. So I am mixing the color just a little bit wherever I feel that I need to add two colors together or three colors together. But overall, I am creating values through the transparency of the paint. So one of the beauties of watercolor is the way it bleeds. So if I have enough color, enough water on the page, the color is gonna bleed into the water. So over here you can see that the first stroke that I put, the water was pretty dry, so I had to add more water. So I find this green to be a little too foresty green, too pine tree green, so I'm adding some yellow into it. As I said, I am not so much interested in the exactity of the color. I am more, I paint pretty fast, so I just go for it. When I sketch with Sharpies or with a gel pen. And when I paint, I use the brush the same way I use the Sharpie. So I'm sketching with the paint on top of the sketch. And if I color it, that it's fine with me. I'm not looking to paint like it's a technique that's called paint by numbers. So you are defining your drawing and then you are filling in the spaces. No, I'm not doing that. I am pretty much redrawing with the brush over the initial drawing in the gel pen. The gel pen that I use, I mentioned before, it's called Red Dot, and I get them at Office Depot, and I really like them because they don't bleed into the paint, they don't dissolve. When I put the wet paint on top, the lines stay solid. And now paint is pretty wet, so while the paint is drying, I am going to draw a hummingbird. I think I would like to, it will make a nice addition to this flower. Here in Jalisco, Mexico, I saw the smallest and cutest hummingbirds that you can imagine. Some of them are the size of a butterfly. They are just quite spectacular. And part of the reason that I don't go for things to be super perfect is that when you look at something, if you are walking in the street or if you are looking at the hummingbird flying, things are not totally still. They are, the wind is blowing, it's moving the flower, it's the hummingbird, it's flying as it's picking up the nectar. And I like to sketch and paint loose because that makes a lot of sense to me. Things are, I'm not painting, especially I'm not painting from a photograph. And even when I paint from a photograph, I transport myself. I imagine to be in the street, to feel the smells, to feel the wind in my hair, to truly be there in the place where that I am painting or sketching. So it's the same when I am sketching and painting these flowers. Now, I am an experienced painter because I've been painting for 30 years and also teaching, and I teach adults. I don't teach kids. It's a different type of learning when you are teaching children. And so if you are looking for a teacher, make sure that your teacher have experience with adults and not kids. It's a totally different way of transmitting the information. And I have been teaching in person for about 30 years, and now I'm teaching online. So if you are interested in learning how to sketch or how to draw or how to use watercolor or acrylics, I'll be happy to work with you. In this moment, I prefer to work with individuals, and I do offer group classes, but at this moment I really feel that it's much rewarding for me and for you to teach you independently. So for example, the option will be to buy classes for a month and to take maybe 2 classes a week and to focus on whatever your interest is. If you are an experienced artist, that's fine. I can also work with experienced painters.